Welcome to Rock'em Sock'em 3, folks. Now, look, last year we showed how the coaches can get on Rock'em Sock'em, okay? This year we're going to give a few tips to the goaltenders. You gotta make those easy saves look dramatic. You know what I mean? All right, now remember this move, folks. Remember this move. Okay, you ready? Let's go. You gotta have a little flair, a little something for the fans. The first guy I saw do this was little Mike Palmateer, and the people loved him. Hey, folks, it doesn't matter how you stop them as long as you stop them. And if you want a hot dog, a little, who cares? The puck didn't go in, did it? And that's all that counts. Here's a few things that drive coaches nuts. Let's start with the playoff hero, John Casey. Kelly Rudy and Larry Robinson do a nice job tucking it home. Here's John Casey again. Hey, we picking on him or what? Now, my buddy Mike Milbury is a little upset about some. Let's see what it is. Uh-oh, two boo-boos on one play. Gary Roberts hammers one, and Moog lets it go through his legs, which makes Mike a little unhappy. Now watch Galley pull the old flamingo and lift his foot. Mike is boiling. Mike says, either block the shot, Galley, or get out of the way. Now I like goalies that show a little spirit. Look at Healy saying, he kicked it in, he kicked it in. And I love Jablonski. Look at, he says at the end of the period, that's right, I played a good period. Hey, who knocked me down? Who knocked me? Oh, it's you, Darren. Oh, I'm sorry if it's okay. And Mike says to Lemelin, you want to go in? He says, well, I don't know. We're losing 8-2. What do you want, a win or a tie? No, I don't want to win. Mike says, well, okay. Nothing makes a coach happier than watching saves like these. Goalies play the hardest position in sports, and when a team loses, you ever notice they always get the blame? Let's watch these beauties, starting with Mikey Vernon. Here's Andy Moog again. Way to go, Andy. John Casey's not letting them in now, folks. Way to go, John. Grant Fuhr, what a goaltender. You can't beat him there. John Casey again. No wonder they made the finals. Look at that kick. Here's John again. Hey, we made fun of him earlier, but not now. Kenny Riggins stops up beauty. Essanov Winnipeg grabs it right out of the air. Picked it out of the net. Beauty. Wendell Young, my good friend for Pittsburgh. Watch him rob 99. Ooh. Mikey Vernon again. Way to go, Mikey boy. And 99 gets stymied by Belfour. Eddie again. Watch that save. Way to go. Dougie Gilmore blasting one at Fuhr. And watch these two great saves by Andy Moog. What a great little guy. How do you like that kick save? Cover it up, Andy boy. Now watch this next one coming up, a little behind the back one. Beauty, Andy, I love those guys. Now here's some tips for the rest of you players. Always listen to your coach. Here's Tommy Watt showing the guys how to get to the bus after the game. And here's Coach Kitchen tells Todd Gill that he's not too happy with his play that period. Sorry, Todd. Pat Burns sparking them up on the bench. Squirting water on Brian Sutter is not the best way to get on the power play, I'll tell you that. Hey, get out of here. Brian Sutter and Mike Keenan during a little brawl in Chicago. Hey, look at the four people listening to the conversation. And there's Brian's brother down in the corner, Rich, listening to see if there's any trouble. He's ready. L.A. Tommy Webster takes a hard shot in the hand. He's saying, who did it? Was that Duchesne again? Was that Duchesne again? Was it? If it is, he's gone for sure. Wayne gets corked on the ear here. Ooh, that hurts. But watch, folks, he doesn't go down. Way to go, Wayne. Drop the gloves, and he says, was that Duchesne? Yeah, it was Duchesne. Was that Duchesne? Jay, was that Duchesne? Yeah, it was. The guy up there says, yeah, Bruce, it was Duchesne. Now, here's the wrong way to hit, folks. Boy, does that hurt. Ooh, I feel sorry for him. And you know, this play sums up the whole Leafs year. Look out, Brad. Linesmen and refs in the National League have the hardest job in sports. Not even safe on the benches. Tough little Carey Fraser never missed a beat here. Beauty. Well, at least this guy tried. He had the right idea. Little Therrien Fleury gives it his all. And now this is the right way to hit, folks. Stern gets caught in the trolley tracks by Boogaboom. Dahlquist nails Brindamore. Snyder and Lazaro collide. Carbonell really hammers Sweeney. Phil Bork and Marquardt muck it up in the corner. One of my favorites, Bob Airey, finds out what happens when you run Bork. Hey, what heck? What's go? Oh, Wang. Hey, geez, I just knocked. Oh, look out. What's happening here? I didn't do nothing. I just hit him once. Leg out. Adam Graves flattened Churla. Keegan levels Hunter. Now for some Gordy specials. Watch Ronnie Stern smack Cavallini. Then Raglan jumps in to help. When you throw those elbows, you better be ready. Two good guys, though. They're ready to go. Nobody hurt. Well, I don't think they were hurt. Gordie Howe would be proud of these elbows. Now comes the mother of all elbows. Dale Hunter almost takes Murphy's head off. That one cost him 4 games. It's even tough for you, Dale. Now, you shouldn't bug the other team. Now, watch Hammond knock Phil Bork down. Gives him a little shot. Another whack by Bork. He gets the penalty. They wave bye-bye. But remember what happened in the playoffs? I know what Adam Graves is trying to do here. He's trying to sucker Basil McRae into a penalty. He's a brave guy because that's a dangerous thing to do. Been in hockey a long time and never saw anything like this before. Imagine if Phil Bork had scored. Bob Probert knocks down Garth Butcher, and Riendo is saying, he did it, he did it. And Probert says, yeah, I did it, and I'm doing this, big mouth. Sun gets you every time in L.A. Watch these fluke goals. Funny how after it goes in, the players raise their sticks like they knew what they were doing. Who are you kidding? Watch this ricochet romance by Al McInnes. Bing, bang, bong. That guy puts him in every way. There's nothing sweeter than to watch Dennis Savard in full flight. Watch this. Nice little pass here. Watch who ends up with trigger man Richie. Nice little pump. Why can't he do that all the time? Watch little Keith Acton show us how it's done. Sneaks by the boards, cuts out in front, puts it in top corner. Oh, he loves it. Watch, watch. Oh, baby. Way to go, Keith boy. Watch Wayne spin a little magic here around the net. Nice little cut to the left, a cut to the right. Nice little dump pass. Watch, it's coming here. Now watch, he goes to the side of the net, puts her home. How did he know where the puck was going to end up? And there's my buddy Marty McSorley. Peter Klima feels like playing, and sometimes he doesn't feel like playing, but when he does feel like playing, nobody is better with the puck. Watch this. Watch him walk out of the fight. Give him a little how's she going, pulls it back, lets on he's going to have a backhand, pulls it in, and tucks her in. He's a beauty. Watch Esa Tiginen go end-to-end. He picks up speed, hits the blue line now. Watch, he's going full tilt. That's tough to stop. Then he puts her home. Gives the old soccer one. Now watch the soccer run. Look, and a beauty helmet. Are you kidding me? Therrien Fleury gives a few Canucks the old how's she going. Drives the goalie right in the back of the net. And now Mario, here we go. Mario said, this puck is going in even if it kills me. This is a goal that sunk the stars. And you you can't get the other coaches mad at you today. They might cream you. Remember when Hunter elbowed Murphy? Well, it looks like Paul Holmgren wants to settle a score. Now, here's a stranger. Dougie Gilmore saying to Tommy Webster, I'm going to be an actor in L.A. And Otto saying, yes, he is, Tommy. Yes, he is. Bang! Tommy Webster nails him. That was a pretty good right. Down goes Dougie Gilmore, proving he is a good actor. Now everybody's into it. You know, everybody says Calgary and Edmonton have bad feelings. I really believe there's batter feelings, and can you say that batter, between these two teams. Now up goes the glass. This is dangerous now, folks. Keep your eye on number 10, Roberts. Now watch him. Keep your eye on him. Look at that glass, boy. Aren't you so glad they have glass between the benches? Give him a little shot. The trainer gives a shot. Now he, little shot back again. Now you've heard of Pheasant under glass. Now we have Roberts under glass. This is dangerous stuff, folks. This is dangerous stuff. And there's Dougie Gilmore on the left saying, Tommy, yes, I am an actor. And you know, folks, he really is going to be an actor. Okay, folks, on this tape, I'm going to answer all the questions you always ask me at banquets, okay? First of all, what bugs me in hockey? I'll tell you what bugs me. Remember Samuelson and Neely last year in the playoffs? You don't remember? Well, we're going to show you. Let's go. Now, this really bugs me, I'll tell you. Watch this cheap shot hit on Cam Neely. See the knee out there? That was the end of the Bruins and Cam Neely for a long time. Cam got up, though, and finished the series and finished the game, being the great guy he is. Get up, Cam. Now, here's what really bugs me. Now, watch Samuelson come in. Now, see the big mass there? Now, watch. He nails Cam right in the face. Cam can't hit him back in the face. Watch him put his visor down on his chest and keep pushing. See the visor down there? That bugs me. Cam gives him a little shot here, though. Hooking and holding. Give him a shot. That's it. Way to go, Cam. Another one. Gee, that guy bugs me. Here he is again. Give him a shot, Cam. Knock that helmet and visor off. You know, when I see this stuff, it makes my blood boil. I'll tell you one thing right now. If this was the old Bruins, there'd be one dead Swedish meatball now. And here's another thing that bugs me. Guys that fight with a visor on. You know why? Because I fought a guy with a visor and I broke my hand one time. I hate this, guys. Look, I don't mind dives like Billy Barber used to do. But to lay there on the ice like you've been shot by a 404 Magnum, it's not the Canadian way to do it. Get up, Darian, get up! And of all guys, Tenorti died. Watch Mike Foligno do a triple somersault. Whoa, around, up, down, beauty. Mario gets a 10 here. Watch this little tap, now watch. And he just, watch this now. Shot. Boom! Oh, around. Looks like Foreman hit him. This is the best one of all. Watch Bob Froese get zonked by Murray Craven. Now watch now. This is what I call a twirl. Down, around. Oh, beauty. He should be in the acting class. Now watch him now. The referee's standing there. He pushes away. Ref, I am really hurt now. Go to one knee now. That's it. Honest, I am hurt. And here's the old blood routine. Makarov. No, he doesn't got any. And now, Mario, yeah, I got it, yeah. Steven says, yeah, that's blood, yeah. 5 minutes there. A couple of years ago, the powers to be moved the benches next to one another. A little dancing here, but they're not dancing over the benches. Now look, Verbeek and Byers going at it. Byers slips on the ice. Milbury pulls them back. Would you believe they got 10 games for Byers, 5 games for Milbury? I just cannot believe it. Why they have the benches next to one another? When are they going to listen to me? Well, at least the glass is holding up better than in L.A. Isn't this ridiculous? Get the benches on the opposite side. I know, you've heard this one before. Yeah, it's Peter Klima's helmet again. I want to ask you, folks, does this helmet not look like a garbage can or what? Hey, and another thing you always ask me, what I was most proud of when I was a coach of the Boston Bruins. Could have been a lot of things, folks, I'll tell you. 4 straight years with 100 points, not too shabby. 4 straight years first in our division, not too bad. A record of 6.58 winning percentage. Whoa, how do you like that one? most wins, now listen to this one, most wins by a Bruin coach ever in their history. Could be coach of the year. Whoop, I love it. But no, I'll tell you what I was proud of the most. 11, 20 goal scorers in 1 year. Think about it, folks. Let's watch. To get 11, 20 goal scorers, everybody on your first three lines must score 20. Also, one forward on your fourth line and a defenseman must score 20. Let's start with Peter McNabb. He got 41. Slider home, Peter. Carey O'Reilly got 29. Captain Hook, Bobby Schmutz, nailed 27. Nice move on Rogie Vachon. Tough little stand, Jonathan here, scoring his first NHL goal. He got 27. Watch this nice pass from Jean Rattel. Way to go, Stanley. Classy Jean Rattel sinks her home. Watch this beauty. Nifty Ricky Middleton scoring one of the nicest goals of all time. Captain Wayne Cashman scores against Rogie Vachon. Hey, does the Sabres always score goals against Rogie Vachon? Are they brutal uniforms or what? Way to go, Cash. Underrated little Greg Sheppard got 23. Nice backhand, Greg. I never realized how good Brad Park was till I watched these films. Watch him smoke one of his 22. Donnie Marcotte, a hockey player's hockey player. When I was having trouble with the line, Donnie would always straighten it out. Now here we are in Toronto, and it's the hardest one to get. It's the record breaker. Now we've got 10 20 goal scorers, and we're all set to go. It's near the end of the game, we're winning 4-3, and for some reason, Roger Nielsen takes out his goalie. Nobody can figure it out. Why? I still don't know. Now, he realizes his mistake, I think. There's Lanny, he wants to go over and play goal. Now, Inspector Crusoe, Wally Harris says, no way, get Tiger Williams out of here right now. Way to go, Inspector. So, here we are, we got a face off. There's Tiger over there telling everybody what to do. Now, they're all set to go. Greg Sheppard against Sittler. Now watch now, they drop it. Greg gets it back to Captain Hook Schmutzy. He slides it over, shoot it, shoot it! He shoots it, and we've got the record, 11, 20 goal scores, never to be broken. There's that good-looking coach, and there, watch the players pile on. The Toronto fans thought we were nuts, they couldn't figure it out, but we know, look at the guys are beating them up, just having fun. What a great bunch of guys. A record, never to be broken. And here's some more records never to be broken, like Gretzky's 50 goals in 39 games. But the Rockets started it all with 50 and 50 back in 45. The Rocket even looked good putting them in with his hand. Watch this. Slicer home. Way to go, Rocket. Mike Bossy zinged this one home on Ronnie Graham for his 50 and 50 in 1981. Nice dance, Mikey. And here's Gretzky's unbelievable 50 and 39 games. I was doing the color on TV in the 39th game. And as a joke, I said, wouldn't it be nice to see Gretzky score 5 tonight? Little did I know. Here's 2. Here's 3. And here's 4. Here comes the fifth one, folks, an empty netter. It's hard to believe, 50 goals in 39 games. He really is the great one. Harry Sawchuk, think of it, folks, 103 shutouts. Imagine how many shots he had to stop to get those. He was like a cat. Can he move or what? Goalies seem to be able to move faster in those days. They don't seem to wear as much equipment or something. He's a beauty. Glenn Hall played 502 consecutive games. Talk about an Iron Man. You'd think he had nerves of steel. I'm sorry, no way. Glenn used to be sick to his stomach before every game. Scotty Bowman said the sicker he got, the better he played. Funny to see the guys with no masks. Love them. Bet you're wondering how you can score 2 goals in 2 seconds. Here's how it's done. Bruins are down by 2 with 12 seconds to go. Kenny Linsman puts that one in. Dougie Gilmore in the faceoff. Watch, instead of pulling it back, he shoots it in. Smart guys, those people from Kingston. Both of them from Kingston. Way to go, Dougie. Think about Bobby Orr's record of plus 128. That means Bobby was on even strength for 128 more goals than scored against him. Guys nowadays are winning the plus and minus with plus 40, plus 50. Imagine, plus 128. Unbelievable.
Don, we need you. I don't know what to say, ladies and gentlemen. What is this?
I've been out here a couple of days, and a couple of my friends, Sly and Arsenio, let me borrow a few things. Yes.
Bill Ranford's in goal. Don Cherry, in case you're wondering who it is.
Well, Billy surely be in, and he'll stand on his head because he's well-rested and Grant needs a rest. I love the people out here. Look at them. Look at this floor director, the lovely people here. I love them. They're absolutely beautiful. They're gorgeous. Well built and the way they walk, and that's just the guys, I'll tell you.
Ron, what's this got to do with the game? I think you've had a little too much sun,
well,
honestly.
I'll tell you, you know, I'm out here and I've been reading the papers, and I can see how people say they really don't want fighting here, and I can see that. The hot weather, the people, I can see why we shouldn't have hockey here. With fights, yes, I can see that.
Do you want to talk about any of the players involved in this classic?
Yes, I want to first of all talk about Kelly Rudy. Here comes Kelly right now. Here's Kelly right. He's coming in right now. And I love the little, we'll pick him up. I love the little blue string that hangs from the back. Don't you? I love him. You can see the little string there. See, isn't that? I think it's blue chiffon. It fits right in with the LA image.
What's with the earring on the left side?
Well, when it's on the left side, that means I'm available. And Good. Not only that, hockey without violence is like a silver ballet.
Who are you picking?
I'm not picking. Let the best team win. Why keep score?
Like you, this one could go either way, I guess. Let's go.
One thing I don't understand. This is the... Harry Neal and I were talking about this. We don't understand a thing. You see, taking it on pardon me?
Right, you don't understand a thing, but go ahead. You and Harry are talking. Sorry to throw you off, but it sounded like you were on the right track, and I just wanted to maintain that flow. No, go ahead. Feel free.
We're told not to be stupid here, and you're acting stupid.
All right.
Okay. Here's this punchy, all right. Now, just
go
let
ahead.
Me. Yeah. Oh, thanks.
Go ahead.
All right.
Give it your best shot.
Von Allman's watching me right now. Don Koharski's a good friend of mine, too.
They're not watching you right now. They're in the middle of a playoff game.
Andy Von Halliman is in his room watching right now, and Koharski's not watching, but they're good friends of mine. I'm going to tell you something. Why don't we? This is me talking, not Hockey Night in Canada.
Right.
This is not CBC. This is not you with your rule book. Why don't we go before the game? I'll tell you. Why don't we have 10 power plays for Buffalo and 10 power plays for Montreal, and we'll get it over with. At least they used to let us have hockey for the first round all the time. And then they'd have 20-minute penalties. I remember Andy last year in Chicago.
He was letting them play, though.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden he must have got the word down. Hey, you're not calling penalties. I mean, let them play the game.
All right, I think I understand you on that. Another strip off the stripes. But you say that all the time. What can Buffalo do to
regroup? No, I don't say it all the time.
Yes, you do.
I put up with it all season, sitting here watching power play after power play. I thought, well, finally we're going into the playoffs. We're going to see some hockey. Come on, we're going to see some hockey. I guarantee you, the second and third period, those penalties aren't called.
Montreal.
Now let's see some hockey.
Montreal.
We invented the game in my hometown, Kingston, Ontario. We have the Hockey Hall of Fame. We put 75% of the players in the National Hockey League, and the Yankee Doodie Dandles are telling us that we can't have a franchise. Now, let's
sit up today.
All right.
And how are you feeling?
Not too good. I got the flu.
This has been going on for about 4 weeks.
How do you get the flu when you get a flu shot?
4 weeks you've had a cold. It's going around. Everybody seems to have it this time of the year. I have a guess, though. Maybe it's cholera.
All right, come on.
A lovely photo in the Edmonton newspapers today. What do you have to say?
I am deep trouble. Deep trouble. I have to admit that is not blue. That's not blue. That's another girl in my lap at a party. You know how you get to those parties, Ron, a weak moment, you have a picture taken, and I go to tell you who took the picture. It was Glenn Sather, my buddy, took the picture, promised me. Never mind, at a party. Took it at a party. I'm not saying where
You've
the party was.
You've been partying with Glenn?
Yes. He said he'd never show that picture of another girl on my lap. He did. She took it to the papers. It was in the papers today, headlines and things like that. So I'm in deep trouble, and you know, all the reporters are after Blue. All the reporters are after Blue. Phone her, Mississauga. I tried to phone and tell her about the girl and all that there. She hung up on me. Hung up on me and everything.
Heartbroken
over the whole thing. And Blue, I know you're watching Mississauga right now. And I want to apologize. It was a weak moment, and that bitch didn't mean a thing to me.
I'm a little surprised at you, I gotta say.
I still love the Bruins. They'll bounce back. Harry will do something. I'll tell you, I love them so much, I still wear their shorts.
I know you don't.
I certainly do wear the shorts, and I'm going to show you. Watch this, right here. Is that not the Boston Bruins shorts right there?
Have you noticed my tie yet?
Yeah, I don't know why. Something's coming here. I don't know what it is.
Wednesday night, you showed me your shorts, which was very kind of you, and I was so impressed. I went out and had a selection of your underwear put on my tie for this evening's telecast.
That's good. A million comedians starving to death, and you're trying to be one.
Yes, I obviously have your shorts in a knot. I refereed a game Tuesday. The Hamilton Kilty Bees put the sting on drug abuse, and they presented this to all of the fans. It's a decal, Don, and I thought you'd like it.
A decal? Yeah. I thought it was a decal.
Well, it's a decal, too.
Decal.
You can stick it someplace. Don Cherry in the Coach's Corner on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Here's another question you always ask me. What was the six greatest hockey players I ever saw? Well, I'm going to start with the greatest hockey player ever, Bobby Orr. Serge Savard said there's players, stars, superstars, and then there's Bobby Orr. Watch this poetry in motion. The old spinorama passes it to Busick, puts her up. Seen that play many times, folks. Look at him, full tilt, never worried about knees or anything. Unbelievable. Watch this move now. Accelerate, accelerate. That made him the difference. Three speeds, the greatest of them all, Bobby Orr. Doug Harvey, 7 Norris, 6 Stanley Cups, 11 All-Star teams, maybe the best all-round defenseman ever. Boy, he could hit, bang, lovely. And when he got the puck, he seemed to run on his skates. Watch this. Even when he, watch him use his feet now. Kick it up, Doug, that's it. Pass it over, watch this goal. They say they didn't have pretty goals back in those days. Top corner, lovely. The spinorama, Danny Gallivan, the first guy. Watch him snap this nice one home. Way to go, Doug. Top beauty. Terry Sawchuk, we've already talked about his shutouts. Now watch Terry weave some magic. Was he a beauty? Move like a cat. Absolutely fearless. See that crouch? Always down. The great one would have been great in any era. He's got the touch. Knows how to move in those holes, and he's got a good shot, as every goalie knows. And here he is, he's breaking Gordie Howe's record. I can't understand how he was standing alone in front. Watch this. Standing all alone, should have been covered. But they can find it, the great ones can find the hole. Is he happy or what? The Golden Jet, Bobby Hall. When Bobby grabbed the puck, the crowd went nuts into their feet. He was a sight to behold. He had the hardest and heaviest slap shot of all. Watch him put that shot in. Watch this now. Feared, feared, Wango.
And what more can be said about Mr. Hockey Gordie Howe? Played till he was 50, and effectively too, might I add. Maybe the best all-round player. Put the puck in, and you better not score on his wing. Coming up, I'll show you why. Watch, he's back-checking, and this guy scores. Lug out. Bingo! But everybody knows I like tough guys, so I'm going to show you my all-time tough team, okay? I'm going to start goal with Ronnie Hextall. Let's go. Ronnie Hextall, Conn Smythe winner. He even gives Hector's goalposts. And he definitely doesn't like anybody hanging around his crease. Just ask Kent Nielsen. Wango. But he can't come up with the big saves. Remember this great save on Craig McTavish. Puts the stick down. Beautiful. But he got another suspension for attacking Chris Chelios. He never forgave Chelios for what Chris did to Prop. First time I've ever seen a goalie as the policeman on the club. And talk about tough guys. How about Prince Albert's pride and joy, Davey Manson? Not only tough, but he can put the puck in. Beautiful. But you'd better watch if you come down his side. Right, Raymond? Scott Stevens getting $1 million and worth every penny. The hardest hitter in the game. Bar none. Let's watch this. He's absolutely fearless. Bingo. Look out. He's a beauty. Unfortunately, these two fine lads don't seem to like each other, as you can see. I'm really glad neither guy got hurt because I love these two guys and I'd hate to see one of them get hurt. They both can throw them. Two tough guys that back down. Never back down from anybody. I'll tell you one thing, if they were on the same team, practice sure would be interesting. Okay, break it up. That's enough for these two guys. Neither guy hurt. Thank goodness. Everybody knows Marc Messier can put the puck in. And Mark doesn't drop the gloves too often, but boy, does he dish out the punishment. Watch this here hit coming out. He's even tough to hit, believe me. He's a mean guy, folks. Remember this classic on Rick Natras? Best elbow I ever saw. Watch Rick. Get up, Rick. At least he didn't stay down. Attaboy. Looks like he's had a few, though. Look at the bench giving him a hard time. Way to go, Rick. Have you ever seen anybody tougher than Bob Probert? I think not. Love this hit. Next one coming up. That was on Todd Gill. Fedosov gets it here. Way to go, Bobby. And he can put the puck in. Watch him sinker home over there. Nice. Now, Daryl Stanley's doing all right with them. Okay, Daryl, you're doing okay. You always get a few in on Bobby for a while, and then he comes on. Watch the helmet go flying. It's okay. He wasn't hurt. Terry O'Reilly, the Tasmanian Devil, just keeps coming at you. Way to go, Terry. And here, Taz. And Paul Holmgren, I'm having a little disagreement right here. But Terry could put the puck in. He led our team in points. Now, you know, with these guys, we're going to have to kill a few penalties. So I'm picking two extra guys. Dan Jonathan, the toughest of them all, even scored tough goals. So tough, saw him get a 10-stitch cut, didn't bleed. Now that's tough. Nice shot, Stan. Big, tough John Wensig. Boy, this guy was something. He got 28 goals, so he was no goon, don't think that. But he can really throw him. Watch this. No takers against the Stars bench. Nobody wanted him. Top corner. Way to go, John.
Well, I know you've been waiting for this part, anxiously awaiting, may I say. Well, maybe something else is coming a little later that you'd rather see. But anyhow, we've got the hits for you, okay? All right, let's go. Hey, heads up! Look out! Sir gets pumped here twice. Picks it up. Way to hit him, Bruins. Sandwich time. Hit those goalies. Watch what happens here. Nice elbow. Boy, she's tough playing in Chicago. Wacko, wacko. Nice pass here. Suey. Ooh, neat time. Cam Neely taking him out in the corner. What a guy. Watch this elbow. Ooh, you don't do that to Big Bird. Flying. Toronto's Billy McCurry catches Wayne with his head down and crunches Wayne with a beauty. Funny thing, folks, Billy never played another shift in the National Hockey League. All right, now we come to the last section. Now, look, I know there's a lot of nice people out there that don't like the odd tussle. I can understand it. They say it's not good for the game. People don't like it. Well, all I know is Wendell Clark, Bob Probert, the most popular guys in their city. So if you don't like the odd tussle, go out into the kitchen and make a pot of tea, okay? Ha! I knew you wouldn't go. Who are you kidding? Listen, let's go right into them. We're going to start with a beauty. Two of my favorites, Darren Kimball and Shane Chirla. Here they go. Watch the lefties go. Boy, I hated fighting lefties. You're always set. One time I get hit so much with rights, I was begging for a left, though. Crowd going crazy. They love it. They love it. Who's kidding who here? Lefty's still going here. Got to get that elbow pad off. Now, nobody got hurt here, folks. Nobody got hurt. Don't worry about it. Here they go with the left. Darren and Shane, two good guys. Strange things happen. The funny thing happened to me one time. I was in a fight. I was in a fight with a guy, and my finger happened to go in his mouth at the side there, and he was biting it right to the bone. Blood was flying, and the harder I hit him, the more he bit. You liking it so far?
Yeah, good.
Yeah. And the more he bit, whacking him, and he's biting, blood's coming all over. I got a big break, though. You know what happened? No. I worked it to the front, and he had no teeth.
And who could forget these two classics between Bobby Probert and Troy Crowder in Detroit? Troy had already run round one in New Jersey, and here was the rematch. Things had to be settled. The next game was in Detroit, and you couldn't believe the electricity in the air. The crowd was buzzing. It was the toughest ticket in town. I phoned the Wings for a ticket. They said, sure, Graves want to see Mario Gretzky. I said, New Jersey. No way, it's been sold out for 3 months. I finally got one at Peanut Heaven. I didn't care, I was there. Two things strike me in these fights. Why doesn't Bobby use tie downs on his sweater? Like that's how he lost in New Jersey, with his sweater over his head. And I believe Troy got his helmet welded on. Funny thing, the night before, I told the linesman I'm coming down to the game, you better not jump in. And as you can see, they did a good job. Again, two good guys that ask no quarter and don't give any.
Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed Rock'em Sock'em 3. Blue and I enjoyed bringing it to you. Thanks for watching. See you later.